Last night we backed up out of the driveway and then the brakes stopped working. We missed that light pole there by a few inches. Peter loves helping with the car. Of course, I'm always right here making sure nothing bad happens. Take the tire off. There's the brake line. This brake line looks fine. Now Peter's going to put the little decal back on. You gotta kind of whack it on now. Whack it again. There you go. You got it. Now we'll do the other side. I took off the other tire and I don't see anything wrong. I just put some brake fluid in the car, then we stepped on the brakes and I got to see all the brake fluid come out. But it was not in the front where you'd think. You'd think it would be that little rubber tube. Turned out we have a puddle by the rear brake. So I have probably a brake line to take care of. I got the brake line off, but you can see that the line, I had to cut it. And then there's a screw that I have to get off. The screw right there. I have to get that one off, but it's being very difficult. It has to come out. Worked on the car again today, and then Janelle went to the ambulance corps building, and she talked to someone there, mentioned I was doing brakes, and he said he'd come over and help me out. So he came over, and as he was pulling in the driveway, the piece finally came free. Right there, that's the piece at the end of an easy out. As he was coming in, finally gave loose, after about 10 days of me working on it. I didn't work on it like the whole 10 days, but off and on. Here's the brake line, and then there's a hole in there. This is the one part that came out without a problem. You're probably wondering how I got the part out after so long. Well, this is what finally worked. This is not all the process because I tried several other things that did not work. So that part there, the screw part, that is what this part was. Obviously it was severely rusted, and what I did is I drilled that out. I had to drill a hole in it. The problem was that I couldn't get a drill inside of here. So what I had to do is I just got a chuck, put a drill in it, then I had to drill it out through there by hand. I just had to turn it by hand, and it took a while. It was doable, but took a little while. And then after I got it drilled, you go in with an easy out. Peter, want to show them the easy out? Okay, so put the easy out right in there. No, just put it in the hole. Okay, there you go. What the easy out does is it's tapered and reverse threaded. So put the thing on there, Peter. Like that. And then what you do is you turn it. What it does is it goes in. It goes into the hole. And then it grips on really tight, and then eventually it comes out. It did take a lot of work, and it's called an easy out. It wasn't very easy though, but it did come out, and that's really all that matters.
That was the stuff that was inside of the blue car.
We're going to the Ford dealership to get a new part for the car. We'll see if they're open. My guess is they're probably closed, but because it's Saturday. But we'll see. Hey, Peter, there's a nice Mustang for you. We're at my shop. I went to my neighbor's house to see if I could borrow a tubing bender to bend this, but he didn't have one or he couldn't find it. So I have to improvise, make my own tubing bender. I have my improvised tubing benders. I just took a dowel and then a lathe, and I cut a little slot in them, and then a file, rounded file, filed them down. And now I have two different diameters to bend the tubing to. Like that, and give it a little bend, see what happens.
Looks like a violin. Or a, what are those things? Crossbows.
This looks like a crossbow?
A bow.
Just gotta make sure you don't kink it. It doesn't look like it's kinking. Let's see here. You gotta bend it almost 90 degrees.
Okay.
There we go. Here, hey, look. There's one bend. Looks like it worked. Let's see which way we need to bend it next. Okay, I gotta bend it about right here. This way. There. Hey, look at that. It's bent by hand. Okay. Gotta bend it back.
Can you bend it back?
Yep, watch. I bent it back. Here's the final product. I am going to install it right now. Got it installed. Now I just have to bleed the brakes, put the tire on, and should be done. Now I just have to bleed the brakes, and Peter's there to help me. And no, he's not going to drive it. Right, Peter? It's really dark, so you can't see it, but the tire is on. The car is done.